previous, you can say, lecture, as I have given you an introduction about 100 dresses, I told you this chapter, it appears in the form of, you can say, a sequel, in which 100 dresses 1 and 100 dresses 2, both the chapters, they represent about a girl named Vanda Pantrowski. So she is made fun of. Why she is made fun of? Because she was uniquely named. Her name was quite long. Moreover, she is coming from Bogans Height. And the students, they disapproved that place because it is not belonging to that of rich people. And the two girls, Peggy and Maddie, as yesterday I have given you the introduction, they were making fun of her. Why they were making fun of her? Because she is always saying that she has 100 dresses all lined up in my closet. But actually, she is daily wearing that blue dress. But what happened? Why Vanda is always listening to them quietly? Does she not have any kind of feelings? Why she is always tight-lipped? She is not answering to any of the questions asked by them. It's not like that she doesn't have the feelings. It's like that she wanted to give a blow at the end. And finally, when she won the drawing competition, that was really a big blow for the two girls and whole of the class. And by the time she has left the school, her father has withdrawn her along with her brother from the school forever, as they both were made fun of. So this chapter, it represents, or it presents the feeling of respect of the individuality of all. And it also raises the issue of bullying, discrimination, and judgmental nature of people. So here goes the chapter. Let us start with the reading. Now I'm going to share with you the chapter that is going to be visible on your screens. And let us start the chapter. Students are still entering. That Monday, Vanda Pantrowski was not in her seat. But nobody, not even Peggy and Madeline. In whole of the chapter, Madeline will be named as Maddie. But actually her complete name was Madeline. The girls who started all the fun noticed her absence. Yes. That Monday means after Sunday, when Monday comes, nobody noticed that Vanda was absent in the class. Why? It is because of the reason that she was not the so celebrated child of the class. Nobody wants to be friend with her. And even Peggy and Madeline, they have not noticed that Vanda was absent that day. Students are still entering and I'm going to get interrupted. But nobody, not even Peggy and Madeline, the girls who started all the fun, noticed her absence. Usually, Vanda sat in the seat next to the last seat in the last row in room number 13. So what was the number of the room where the class was situated? It was room number 13, where she is always sitting. She is always sitting in the seat next to the last, it means second last seat of the last row. Imagine that girl is always sitting at the back. Nobody is paying attention to her and nobody wants to be a friend with her. This is the reason why she's always sitting and nobody even notices her absence. Moreover, Peggy and Maddie, who have started all the fun, who have started all kind of, you can say, fun with Vanda, even they have not noticed that she was absent. She sat in the corner of the room where the rough boys who did not make good marks sat. The corner of the room where there was most scuffling of feet. Scuffling means moving of shoes and the noises produced. Rough boys mean those who are not at all intelligent. Most roars of laughter when anything funny was said and most mud and dirt on the floor. So you can very well imagine the situation and the kind of environment that is prevailing in the last rows of the class. So those who are the lords of the last benches, so they are always talking, making noise, and whenever anything funny is said in the class, they are always laughing aloud, creating nuisance and creating problem in the class, distracting others. And They are not neatly dressed up. Their shoes are covered with mud, and because of scuffling of the shoes, they are scratching their shoes onto the ground, leading to mud everywhere on the ground. And there she was sitting. Has she not ever felt that she should sit with other girls? Has she ever not felt that she should enjoy the company of other girls? Of course, she is a girl. She wanted. But actually, because she is made a figure of fun by Peggy and Maddie, this is the reason why she is always sitting there and complaining never. She is never complaining about her condition and about the kind of behavior she was suffering from. But she was so deeply hurt that she is not talking to anybody about it. Wanda did not sit there because she was rough and noisy. It was not that she was noisy because she wants to make noise during the class, but on the contrary, she was very quiet and rarely said anything at all. She was a very quiet girl and she is never saying anything at all in the class, never participating in any kind of discussions among the children. And nobody had ever heard her laugh out aloud. And nobody has ever heard her that if something funny happened in the class, she is laughing aloud. She is always contented in her work, constrained to her work, doing her work and never paying attention towards the matters of others, never discussing things with others, never participating in any kind of discussions, and never saying a word. Sometimes she twisted her mouth into a crooked sort of smile, but that was all. But sometimes when she's tempted to laugh, she just twists the corner of her one corner of her mouth in the form of a crooked smile, and that was all. That was all means that was the only kind of expression that was being displayed by Wanda. Now, nobody knew exactly why Wanda sat in that seat, unless it was because she came all the way from Boggins Heights and her feet were usually caked with dry mud. So nobody knew why she is always sitting there. But the most possible reason was that is only that she is coming from Boggins Heights, which is not so posh area, which is situated up at the top of the hill and where people of, you can say, lower order, they used to live. They are not so rich people. And ultimately, whenever she is coming from Boggins Heights, because she is covering a large distance to come there, her feet is always caked with mud, covered with mud. But no one really thought much about Wanda Petrowski once she sat in the corner of the room. But when she used to come into the class and used to sit in the corner seat of the class, nobody pays attention towards her. So from these three paragraphs, we have the clear idea what kind of girl Wanda Petrowski was, why she's made fun of, and why the children did not like her, because she is coming from Boggins Heights and everyone was trying to make fun of her. And she is always sitting with rough boys, those who are making noise, passing funny remarks, making nuisance, creating nuisance in the class. But she is not that sort of girl. But still she is sitting there and nobody has ever heard her laugh. It means she is reserved in her nature. The time when they thought about Wanda was outside of school hours at noon time, when they were coming back to school, or in the morning early before school began, when groups of two or three or even more would be talking and laughing on their way to the schoolyard. So nobody remembers of Wanda Petrowski, but it is the only two times when they are remembering about her. It is before coming to the school, entering the school premises, when they were talking, laughing with each other. They are coming to school on the way. And the other one, when they were complete hours of the school, they will be over. They were going to their homes at noon time and finally talking with each other. And at that time, they remember Wanda Petrowski. But what is particular? At that time only, it is because they are not under any kind of authority. They are free to speak and free to do whatever they want. And at that time, or the children, they chose that time in order to tease Wanda Petrowski. Then sometimes they waited for Wanda to have fun with her. Sometimes if they don't see Wanda, they used to stand there also in order to have fun with her. The next day, Tuesday, Wanda was not in school either, and nobody noticed her absence. But just a moment, please. So, the next day, Tuesday, Wanda was not in school. On Tuesday, she did not come to school and nobody even noticed her absence. Why? Because nobody was her friend. She's sitting alone. But on Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie, who sat down front with her other children, who got good marks and who didn't track in a whole lot of mud, did notice that Wanda wasn't there. Peggy was the most popular girl in school. So, but on Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie, who used to sit in the front rows, why? Because there the students who get good marks, they used to sit and their feet are never covered with mud. They used to come there and sit, and where Peggy and Maddie were sitting, Peggy noticed that she was absent in the class. Why she was absent? It is because of the reason that she was made fun of. So let us see. And did not notice that Wanda wasn't there. Peggy was the most popular girl in the school. Peggy was also the most intelligent girl in the school. She was pretty. She had many pretty clothes and her hair was curly. And Maddie was her closest friend. So this is the complete look of Peggy that is being given. She has curly hair, one of the most intelligent girl in the class, most popular in the class. And her closest friend was Maddie. The reason Peggy and Maddie noticed Wanda's absence was because Wanda had made them late to school. Why they were remembering that Wanda was not present? Because it is because of Wanda that they have come late to school. They have come late to school because of Wanda. Yes, because they were waiting for Wanda to come so that they can play some game with her. They can have fun with her. They had waited and waited for Wanda to have some fun with her. And she just hadn't come. But she didn't turn up, and it is because of the reason of their wait that they were late to the school. They often waited for Wanda Petrovsky to have fun with her. Wanda Petrovsky. Most of the children in room 13 didn't have names like that. They had names easy to say, like Thomas, Smith, Alan. There was one boy named Bound, Billy Bound. And people thought that was funny, but not funny in the same way that Petrovsky was. So what is the main reason why Wanda Petrovsky was made fun of? Wanda was made fun of, it is because of the reason that she has a unique and long name. And moreover, other children, they have very short and small names like Thomas, Smith, Allen. And one child was also there in the class, Billy Bum. And the children feel that it is also very funny. But Petrovsky is more funny than that of Billy Bum. Wanda didn't have any friends. She came to school alone and went home alone. She always wore a faded blue dress that didn't hang right. It was clean, but it looked as though it had never been ironed properly. So Wanda, she did not have any friends. I told you she's all alone in the school. She came to school alone. She comes to school alone, go back alone. Nobody is her friend. And she's always wearing one faded blue dress. Daily she's wearing, which is not fitting her properly. It is little bit loose one also, but of course it is clean every day. And moreover, it is also not ironed properly. She didn't have any friends. But a lot of girls talked to her. Sometimes they surrounded her in the schoolyard as she stood watching the little girls play hopscotch on the worn hard ground. What is hopscotch? Hopscotch, you know, it is a game that the girls used to play, in which they draw some squares onto the ground and they used to jump one after the other square. In your Punjabi language or Hindi, you call it as tapu, hopscotch. So what she's saying, she's not friend of any of the girls most of the time, but many girls, they used to wait for Wanda. Why? Because they wanted to have some fun with her. Sometimes in the schoolyard, in the open ground, they used to follow her. She is always surrounded by a number of girls in the schoolyard. And why? Because she used to stand there and watch other girls hopscotch. It means that nobody is allowing her to play with them also. But still other people, they used to surround her. Why? Wanda, Peggy would say in a most courteous manner, as though she were talking to Miss Nelson. Yes. So Peggy, she would call in a few with a funny feeling in her mind, and with very much respect, she is calling Wanda. Wanda, she would say, giving one of her friends a nudge. Nudge means, for example, gentle push with your, you can say like this, gentle push with your elbow, so that you wanted to signify, now see what I'm going to do with her. Tell us, how many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your closet? So this is how Peggy is making fun of Wanda. She's asking, okay, Wanda, tell me, how many dresses you have in your closet? 100, Wanda would say. I have 100 dresses. 100, exclaimed all the little girls incredulously. Incredulously means showing much belief. They were saying, 100, wow. And the little ones would stop playing hopscotch and listen. And the small girls, they would stop and listen to her. Really, she has 100 dresses. This is unbelievable. Yeah, 100, and all lined up, said Wanda. Then her thin lips drew together in silence. Then afterwards she would say, yes, I have 100 dresses and all lined up in my closet, all lined up in my closet. And moreover, after that, she closed her lips in a tight manner and would not say anything else than that. What are they like? All silk, I bet, said Peggy. Peggy, again in a taunting manner, she would say, okay, 100 dresses you have. Then what material they are made of? Made up of? I think all are of silk, because silk is very costly. And she knew that she could not afford that. Yeah, all silk and all colors. I would say, yes, I have of all silk, all the dresses of silk and of all colors. Velvet too? Peggy would say, you have a velvet also. Again, a costly material. Yeah, velvet too. 100 dresses, Wanda would repeat, solidly all lined up in my closet. And Wanda, solidly means without showing any feeling, she would say, yes, I have a velvet too and all lined up in my closet. Then they would let her go. And then before she would gone very far, they couldn't help bursting into shrieks and peals of laughter. So, finally, after that, making fun of her, they would allow her to go. And then before she was gone very far, they could help bursting into shrieks and peals of laughter. And before Wanda could go farther, they would laugh together in a loud manner, and they burst into laughter as they were making fun of her, that she's saying she's having 100 dresses. Impossible. Then why she's wearing this blue dress again and again? 100 dresses. Obviously, the only dress Wanda has was the blue one she wore every day. Yes. So finally, what she had, then afterwards, but everyone knew that she had only one dress. Okay, which one dress? That is the faded blue dress that she was wearing. Why she is wearing that faded blue dress? It is because of the reason that she was only having that faded blue dress, and daily she is wearing that. So, How many shoes did you say you had? 60 pairs and all lined up in my closet. Then one girl would say, then how many pair of shoes you have? 60 pairs and all lined up in your closet means the same manner that she was speaking. They were making fun of her. Cries of exaggerated politeness greeted this. All alike. Then, but she was very polite. Exaggerated means extended. More than normal. This politeness, it greeted this and Pearson. All are of same size. Oh no, every pair is different. All colors and all lined up. Yes, oh, she said, oh yes, every pair is different and I have of all colors and all lined up. Peggy, who had thought up this game, and Maddie, her inseparable friends, were always the last to leave. So all the girls were making fun of Wanda, and Peggy and Maddie, they were the last to leave from there. Why? Because it was Peggy who had started this game. But Maddie, was she really willing to be a part of this game? Maybe yes, maybe not. But she was inseparable friend of her. She is not, by her will also, can't be separated from her. But deep inside, she has a feeling that they should not do this to Wanda again and again. She is feeling hurt. Finally, Wanda would move up the street, her eyes dull and her mouth closed, hitching her left shoulder every now and then in the funny way she had, finishing the walk to school alone. So in this manner, Wanda would go, her face down, her eyes, but in her thoughts, she may be rebuking them. She may be feeling bad for what they have done with her. And she's twitching, means raising up her shoulder. Maybe she's answering the question in her mind, what Peggy and Maddie and other girls have asked her. And in this manner, she used to cover the rest of the walk to the school alone. So what it means? It means that she is all alone. Nobody is her friend. She is always playing in this manner. Okay? And ultimately she is made fun of. Why? Because she had on that blue dress. Peggy was not really cruel. She protected small children from bullies. But actually, was Peggy of that sort that she is making fun of other children always? No. She is doing this only with Wanda. Otherwise, she is not really cruel. She is always protecting other children from being bullied by others. Bullying means that when the senior ones, they tease junior ones in order to bring things for them, in order to tease them, in order to follow them. And she cried for hours if she saw an animal mistreated. She is so little-hearted that if she see any animal mistreated, then ultimately, what she would do, she would cry for longer. She has such a soft heart. Then why is she doing this with Wanda? If anybody had said to her, don't you think that is a cruel way to treat Wanda? She would have been very surprised. Cruel? Why did the girl say she had 100 dresses? If anybody would say to Peggy, you have such a soft heart, then why are you making fun of Wanda? She would say, fun with Wanda? She's never feeling sorry for that. Why? Because she said if she does not have those 100 dresses, why she is always telling she had 100 dresses? Anybody could tell that. That was a lie. And why did she want to lie? And she wasn't just an ordinary person else. Why did she have a name like that? Anyway, they never made her cry. So finally she said, why she's an ordinary person and why she had such a long name and of different type? She should behave in a normal manner. She is not a normal girl. And this is the reason why she has done all this to her. But one thing is that it is never because of Peggy that she has cried. Okay? So, as for Maddie, this business of asking Wanda every day how many dresses and how many hats and how many this and that, she had bothering her. Maddie was poor herself. She usually wore somebody's hand-me-down clothes. Hand-me-down clothes mean the clothes which were used by somebody, and when they were given a new finish, she's wearing that. But Maddie, she was not at all interested in all this. She is feeling really very bad for. She is really feeling very bad for that person who is making fun of Wanda. And moreover, she is also feeling very bad for Wanda that she is made fun of just because she is wearing just one blue dress daily. And moreover, she thought she should not be a partner in this crime. But she herself was poor. Because she herself was poor, she knew that what kind of feeling she would have. So she usually wore somebody hand-me-down clothes. She is also not wearing fresh clothes or the new clothes. She is always wearing hand-me-down clothes. Thank goodness. She didn't live up on Bargain Heights or have a funny name. But she was thankful to God. Oh God, thanks. At least my name is not like that of Wanda. And moreover, I'm not living in Bargain Heights. Sometimes when Peggy was asking Wanda those questions in that mocking, means funny, polite voice, Maddie felt embarrassed and studied the marbles in the palm of her hand, rolling them round and saying nothing herself. So when Peggy used to make fun of Wanda in this manner, she had marbles in her hand and she used to count those marbles and ultimately moving them round and round. What this shows her impatient nature, that she wanted to speak, but she did not have the courage to speak. But she's feeling sorry for that, but she could not speak. This shows her incapability of the situation to handle. Not that she felt sorry for Wanda exactly. She would never have paid any attention to Wanda if Peggy hadn't invented the dresses game. So it is not because she's feeling sorry for Wanda, but she said she was feeling that if Peggy would not have started this game, she would not have paid any attention to Wanda. But suppose Peggy and all the others started in on her next, she wasn't as poor as Wanda perhaps, but she was poor. She thought that if this is going to be played with Wanda today, tomorrow maybe I'll be the new victim because she's also poor. And moreover, but this is also the reason she's not as poor as Wanda. Of course, she would have more sense than to say she had 100 dresses. Moreover, she thought that I'm more sensible, that I'm not always saying that I have 100 dresses. Still, she would not like for them to begin on her. She wished Peggy would stop teasing Wanda Pinkowski. But she never wished that this should be started with her. And moreover, she always wanted that Peggy should stop making fun of Wanda. So this is how we have started, that how Peggy and Maddie, they were making fun of Wanda. But actually, what it was not actually Maddie who is willingly involved in all this. Actually, she was unwillingly a part of this. She wanted to stop that, but this, all this still here shows her incapability, her lack of guts that she should stand against the wrong. So tomorrow we will continue further.